This is the November 2022 CAPS Dbe Nsc exam, paper 1, question 3. It's given that the general term of a quadratic number is this, and the first term is 7. Show that b, so b the unknown over there, is equal to 4. Okay. So our general term is n squared plus bn plus 9. And the first term of the first differences is 7. The first term of the first differences is 7. So I look at this and I see it's quadratic. It's a quadratic sequence. And for quadratic sequences, you know, usually you'd have T1, T2, T3, and then you'd find the first differences, difference between T2 minus T1 over here. And the first difference, T3 minus T2. And then it has a second difference that is common. So the second differences are equal to each other for quadratic sequences. The quick method to find the A, B, and C, so if AN squared plus BN plus C, A, B, and C is, somebody worked it out for us already. So I draw these two lines, and it's 2A will be equal to the first difference. The middle one is 3A plus B. This one is actually equal to the second difference. 3A plus B is equal to the first difference. And the third column here is to get term one. Which is your A. Term one is going to be A plus B plus C. So usually we would be doing this sort of the other way around. If we start subbing in things that we know, the requirements of this one, so this is your second difference here. We know that from what was given that our A value is actually 1. So we know then that 2 times 1 is going to be our second difference. So our second difference is 2. Our second difference will be equal to 2. From there, we can also substitute the A value into 3A plus B. 3A is 1 plus B is going to be equal to our first difference. If I recall, the first term of the first differences, so the first term of the first differences is 7. So this was given to us as 7. This was given to us. Here we can work out what B is, and B was the unknown. They asked us, is B equal to 4? Prove it. So if we take B, 7 minus 3, we'll get B is equal to 4. And that answers the first question in this question 3. B is, in fact, equal to 4. Looking at question 3.2, they ask, please determine the 60th term of this number pattern. So they want the 60th term. They want, what is T60? Well, we know that n squared plus 4n plus 9 is our general term. So T60 is just subbing in 60 wherever you see an n. So it's the 60th term. And put this into your calculator, we'll get that the T60 is equal to 3849. Number 3.3, Determine the general term for the sequence of the first differences of the quadratic number pattern. Write your answer in this form. So they want the general term, not of the quadratic pattern, but they want the general term of the first differences. So we just go back to our quick method again. We had our A was 1. So our second difference is going to be equal to 2. And in the middle here, we had that our B is equal to 4. For the third step, we needed A plus B plus C, and this will give us the first term. This is going to give us term 1. A plus B plus C, we know that A is 1 because it was given. B is 4. That was also given in a previous question, but what we don't know is what C is. We don't know what C is yet. So if we look at the information we have so far, how can we figure out, C is also given. C is given. Okay, good. T1, 9 plus 4 plus 1, add those together, and our first term is 14. So we have our first term as 14, and we know that our first difference is 7. So the difference between, so if we add 14 and 7, we get 21. So 14 plus 7 is 21. So our second term here would be 21. And you might not need this, or just to show you how it kind of works, we also know that our second difference is equal to 2. Our second difference is equal to 2. And we know that because it's quadratic, we have a constant second difference. So we can count 2 plus 7 to find our second first difference, and that would be 9. And we could count 21 plus 9, and that would make 30. From there, we can give another second difference. We know that the second difference is always going to be 2. And so our next second difference is 11. And here we have 3 terms of our first differences. I've just checked back on the question. It said, it wants the general term for the first differences. So once you've got 3 terms of the first differences, you're already almost there. So using 7, 9, and 11 as our general term, if you look at the form we were given, that looks like a straight line, so it must be an arithmetic pattern, but we can check. Obviously, it is an arithmetic, we know, because we're plusing 2 each time. The second difference is the same, so this must be arithmetic. We know what our D is. We know what our A is. So the last step is to just use whatever method you use to find the formula. So what I use is the A plus N minus 1 D. It's my favorite formula, and so A is 2, N minus 1, and 7, D is also, A is 7, and D is 2. I finish it off, you just times these in, so it'll be 2N minus 2, 2N minus 2 plus 7. And finally, our general term is 2n, 7 minus 2 is 5, plus 5. And that's, they ask for a general term, so just to make sure you say TP. TP is equal to 2n plus 5. 3.4, which two consecutive terms in the quadratic number pattern have a first difference of 157? I understand this to being sort of some sort of position, let's call it rather position A. So some sort of position A to some sort of position B, and these two terms must be next to each other, have a first difference of 157. And it wants to know what A and B are. So which two questions have a first difference in the quadratic number pattern? So we take the first difference formula. Dp from the previous question, and we know that this is the first difference here. So we can put this and equate it in order to find an n, to find a suitable n, work out which n we're doing. So 157 equal to 2n plus 5. Now quickly, a little bit of algebra. Minus 5 on both sides, 152, divide by 2 on both sides over 2 equals n. N is then 76. So it's going to be from the 76th term to the 77th term. So between which two terms? It's going to be between the 76th and the 77th term. And that concludes question 3. Please like if you like my videos and subscribe.